you, thank you. Isn't that a beautiful way to welcome in the end of Sunday? So for those of you who are surfing the net on YouTube and stumbled into this beautiful music, you are in First Reformed Church's Jazz Vespers of Schenectady, New York. So we welcome our live audience and our cyberspace audience. So Jazz Vespers is all about letting go of the week we just had and being reflective of the week we're yet to have. And what a week that we've had, right? We've had a very unique lunar eclipse, and we've had these little bugs come out of emerging after 17 years, known as cicadas, right? And we have the lessening of the pandemic. Yay for scientists for giving us the vaccine. And so we are here tonight. And another first for Jazz Vespers, after about a year and a half, right, Peggy? We can have refreshments once again in a safe manner. So we're very informal for the live audience. If you have the hungers, feel free to go over. And the musicians told me their theme tonight is Moon or Luna. So to kick us off, we have a poem entitled Moonlight, Summer Moonlight. 'Tis moonlight, summer moonlight, all soft and still and fair, the solemn hour of midnight breathes sweet thoughts everywhere, but most where trees are sending their breezy boughs on high, or stooping low are lending a shelter from the sky. And there in those wild bowers a lovely form is laid, green grass and dew-steeped flowers wave gently round her head. This poem is brought to us by Emily Jane Bronte. So welcome.
Thank you.
you. So I'm going to let the musicians introduce themselves. Who's on the piano?
I'm Michael Lamkin.
And?
That was Moon River, as you probably knew. We just played. This is Pete Toigo on bass.
Thank you.
As you probably already know. Probably already know him. And actually, I should mention that the first one we played was also a moon theme. It was called Moon Rays by Horace Silver.
Ooh.
All our music is going to be moon themes. And did you want to do a poem?
Do you want me to do a poem, or would you like to play again?
Whatever you want to do.
I'm going to read a poem.
Okay,
we're going to read a poem. So I mentioned that the week that we had also had our little insect friends unearthing themselves after 17 years, the cicadas. And so I have this poem. At the end of summer, whine as though a pine tree is bowing a broken violin, as though a bandsaw cleaves 1,000 thin sheets of titanium. They chime like freight wheels on a Norfolk Southern slowing into town, but all you ever see is silence. Husk glued to the underside of maple leaves with their 1950s bakelite lines, they do just as well hanging from a ceiling of a space museum. What cicadas leave behind is kind of a crystallized memory, the stubborn detail of the shape around a live turn, the color of forgotten things, a cold broth of tea and milk in the bottom of a mug, or skin on an old tin of varnish you have to lift with lineman's pliers, or a paper that hung 30 years in Bird Cooper's pantry in Brighton. So our friends came to say hello at the end of our pandemic, almost end, and they're sort of like us. We're reemerging. And it felt like 17 years, right? And so here we are to tell our story of reemergence, and we have music to welcome that.
This one's called Old Devil Moon.
Thank you.
So here we are listening to musicians, and part of our theme is reemergence. And I read an article in the New York Times that the New York City summer hustlers are back, and I don't mean that in a bad way. They're people who earn their livelihood by providing services that you can do in the summer, such as tour guides, walking tour guides, outdoor performances, and outdoor musicians. So I don't know how many of you have ever been in New York City for any period of time. You always encounter a musician on the street and on the subway, and they have a special place in my heart. So the Poetry Foundation gave me a poem entitled Busking, B-U-S-K-I-N-G, which means playing for money to put in your suitcase. The day folds up like money if you're lucky, mostly sun, a cold coin, drumming into the blue of a guitar case. Close up and head home. Half a hundred times I wanted to hock those six strings, or hack if I could, my axe into firewood. That blaze never lasts. I begged myself hoarse, sung street corner and subway over a train's blast, through stale air and trash. You've seen me, brushed right by me. My strings screech and light up like a third rail. Mornings I am fed by flies, strangers, and sunrise. So here's to all the street musicians and subway musicians that can come home again and play for us. And here's our Jazz Vespers musicians. Thank you. So what was the name of that song?
That's called Moon Glow.
Ooh.
It's an old standard. I don't know which one. Will Hudson, Eddie Lang, or Irving Mills, which one wrote the lyrics and which one wrote the music, do you know? It's a kind of an unusual grouping. I think Irving Mills is probably the most well-known one, but the other ones I'm not familiar with.
Well, great interpretation by the two of you. Thank you.
Thank you.
I've been asked by our at-home audience to give us the names of the poets. So the poem entitled Cicadas at the End of the Summer was published in the Poetry Foundation, and the author is Martin Walls, W-A-L-L-S. The poem about busking was also published in the Poetry Foundation, and the author's name is Kevin Young, Y-O-U-N-G. So thank you, audience, for reminding me to do that. I appreciate that. And I have a poem about the moon. Again, from the Poetry Foundation, the author is Josephine Miles, M-I-L-E-S, entitled Cage. Through the branches of the Japanese cherry, blooming like a cloud which will rain, a rain white as the snow, the living room across the roadway cuts its square of light, and in it fight two figures, hot, irate, stuck between sink and sofa in that golden cage. Come out into the night, walk in the night. It is for you, not me. The cherry flowers will rain as their rain as white, cool as the moon. Listen how they surround. You swing among them in the cage of light. Come out into the night. Cage by Josephine Miles. Thank you.
Thank you.
What was that name?
It's called Night Dreamer by Wayne Shorter.
Ooh, that was really pretty.
He's a big, great, fantastic composer, and probably one of his best tunes, I think.
It's beautiful.
Yeah, thank you. So this poem intrigued me, and I'll give you the backdrop for it. This is by the author. About this poem, we've had terrible wildfires late last summer in Southern California. The last one filled the sky with smoke and white ash that fell everywhere and also generated what's called a blood moon, a strange red orbit that rose at dusk in the altered heavens. My friend Bill and I have been to a gallery opening featuring some wonderful paintings that appeared childlike to me and connected to Bill's earlier photographing of this blood moon, and it all came together in this poem. And the author is Carol Musk, M-U-S-K-E, Dukes, D-U-K-E-S, and it's entitled Wildfire Moon, Summer, L.A. Pale ash falls from the sky. On the lanai, a child finger paints a big red sun, twin to the one that burns above, mirror on fire. What does the sun see through pages of smoke? Hills, winged, the horizon brazen as a great fool's gold jet landing on sparkler wheels. She catches it. The revolving star atop a police cruiser, reflecting in a flash, the blood moon coming up at dusk, printing her name in what we call stardust. No one can look for long into a burning mirror. Our faces break up into bloodshots. Still, her small fingers work ash onto a pink soul-lit version of a planet unlike ours. Its moon withdrawing into lit craters. Witness how she rises, even in this sullen white downfall, watching over the inedible rems of touch. No one else will render it so, a world on fire burning within this world that her fingers summon tonight, arriving wild bright and never again. So isn't that beautiful? So thank you, Carol Musk Dukes, for giving us that beautiful poem, and musicians, beautiful music. about you, but that put me in a very mellow place. It helped me let go of last week, so thank you. At this point, if we had a minister, we might do a prayer, but what I like to do is ask people, both in our home audience and our in-person audience, if there's anything you'd like to have us think about somebody who needs our thoughts and prayers, a person, a place, a thing. Is there some place in the world we should give a special nod to and think about and hope for them?
New graduates
as they enter the world. Oh, nice. So we wish them the best in their future endeavors, right? Because they're our future leaders. Yes. That's a good thought. Thank you. Anything else? Well, I would like to say a thank you to all that made us handle the pandemic. From the healthcare workers, to teachers who did it under such trying times, to parents who had to homeschool their children, to the scientists who created the vaccine, to the public health workers to put it into our arms, to the grocery store workers who stayed open for us, and to our neighbors that helped each other, got food, took in mail, etc. So I think there's a lot of people out there we need to send both our known heroes and our silent heroes who picked the pace up, don't you think? And they did without asking to do it. So a big shout out to everybody, correct? And those that needed help, you were very brave in asking for help. So a shout out for you as well. And I want to thank our musicians and Nathan, who kept coming here week after week, even when we were shut down, and provided a beautiful space for us every Sunday from 5 to 6. Correct? Yeah. So I have a poet who some people might be familiar with, Amy Lowell, and she wrote a poem back in the day, called The Crescent Moon. Slipping softly through the sky, little horned, happy moon, can you hear me up so high? Will you come down soon? On my nursery window still, will you stay your steady flight, then float away with me through the summer night, brushing over tops of trees, playing hide and seek with stars, peeping up through shiny clouds at Jupiter or Mars. I shall fill my lap with roses gathered in the Milky Way, all to carry home to Mother. Little rocking, sailing moon, do you hear me shout ahoy? Just a little nearer, moon, to please this little boy. Isn't that a sweet little lullaby? Thank you. say a thank you to Pete and Mike and Nathan. Woohoo! Come on. So this concludes, our Jazz Vespers for this Sunday. I just want to remind us that Jazz Vespers is a self-supporting ministry, and if you feel like you would like to contribute, there's a box outside. You can also do it online, I believe, Peggy, correct? And also send in something through the mail to the church, First Reformed Church in Schenectady on North Church Street. Next week, we will have Joe Doolittle as our host and Max Kaplan as our musician, and Nathan will be our technical manager over here. So we have a good team in this church and at Jazz Vespers. So thank you all for coming. Go out and enjoy the world this week in a very mellow place. So I'll see you all. Thank you. Oh, and there's snacks, so help yourselves.